Now, just because someone looks thin doesn't mean they're healthy. In fact, I see patients all the time who are lean, but are struggling with fatigue, poor metabolic health, and even pre-diabetes and leaky gut. Now, some say that visceral fat is the culprit, the kind you can't see in the mirror. But in my practice, I see the problem being a fatty liver and insulin resistance. Now, before we go on, quick reminder, if you find this helpful, be sure to subscribe and leave a review. So, what is skinny fat? So, skinny fat refers to people who appear lean but actually carry dangerous fat inside their bodies. And as I've written about in Gut Check, fascinatingly, 50% of normal weight individuals have insulin resistance and metabolic inflexibility. Whoa, 50%. So this fat collects around the organs, in your liver, in your pancreas, along your intestines, and even on the fat on the surface of your heart. Just to entertain you, there are very good studies in cardiac disease showing that the more fat that you have on the surface of your heart, around your blood vessels, the more coronary artery disease and inflammation you have in those blood vessels. In fact, many times as a surgeon, we would see skinny patients who were operating on for heart disease, for blockages in their coronary arteries, where they have so much inflammation in the fat on their coronary arteries that we literally peel off scar tissue off the top of their coronary arteries to get to their arteries. All from that fat. And it doesn't show up on the surface. These people are not fat, but the fat is inside. When I was a general surgeon, we had to be a general surgeon before we could become heart surgeons, we would see this same fat on the surface of the intestines, in the omentum, in the fat in our belly. And we would see it in our patients with fatty liver disease. So just because you don't carry it on the outside, doesn't mean it isn't on the inside. And almost all of these people, when I look at their blood work, they may have absolutely no markers of diabetes. They may have a normal blood sugar, fasting glucose. They may have a normal hemoglobin A1C. I know you've heard that word. Every night on TV, you hear, I got my A1C down. A1C basically looks at how you handle sugars and proteins over the 2 months prior to the test on average. And yes, we do use that to look for people who are pre-diabetic or diabetic. But until we started looking at fasting insulin levels and measures insulin resistance, we didn't realize that many of our patients who were normal weight, who often feel tired or inflamed or just off, had elevated insulin levels and insulin resistance. Again, 50% of normal weight people have this issue. So even though your weight is normal, even though your blood sugar is fine, and even though your doctor tells you that your hemoglobin A1C is in the normal range, don't bet on it. Make sure you ask your doctor for a fasting insulin level. And quite frankly, we're getting more and more draconian with how low a normal insulin level should be. It should basically be 6 or less. I'll take 9 or less, but if your insulin level is in the 10, 15, 20, you have insulin resistance. And please ask your doctor or healthcare provider to measure a HOMA-IR. That's capital HOMA-IR. IR stands for insulin resistance. And you'll be shocked. Most of the time, it's going to be elevated, even though you've been told you're perfectly fine. So, yes, we do see visceral fat. But visceral fat, for years, we have been told that visceral fat is the cause of inflammation, and that fat cells are metabolically active, and they're producing all this inflammation. I beg to differ. Fat isn't the problem. It's the inflammation that's producing that fat storage that's the problem. Now, you don't store fat in your belly from some magical process. If you've read any of my recent books, you know that there's a war going on down there. 80% of all your immune cells, your body's infantry, is down there doing battle against whatever is coming through leaky gut. And so there's a war going on in your belly. And as any general knows, troops travel on their stomachs. And you have to have stores of fat to support the troops. And that's why we store fat in our belly. The visceral fat is not the cause of all this inflammation. It's the inflammation from the war going on that prompts the storage of fat. Same way in the heart. It's the inflammation on the blood vessels that's prompting the storage of fat to give our troops doing battle along the walls of our blood vessels. Many patients with high visceral fat have fatigue, they have brain fog, and remarkably, they have leaky gut and gut dysbiosis. And that's the reason why it's so mischievous. Now, you actually have three kinds of fat in your body at any one time. We have brown fat, and we have white fat, and we have fat that's kind of transitioning from white fat to brown fat, and it's called, you guessed it, beige fat. Now, white fat is your body's energy storage system. It's white because these fat cells are very low in mitochondria, and we basically have an unlimited number of fat storage cells. And these do build up around your belly and organs. Now, on the other hand, brown fat is packed with mitochondria. And that's why it actually appears brown under the microscope. Now, you were born with deposits with brown fat, particularly in between your shoulders and kind of deep in your chest. And brown fat's primary job is to generate heat, not store energy. Now, brown fat was very useful to keep infants warm before they could ingest enough calories to do it themselves. Now, unfortunately, we tend to lose brown fat as we age. Supposedly, we no longer need much brown fat to keep warm. But that's actually why cold exposure is great, because it actually activates brown fat making heat. And the more cold exposure you're exposed to, the more you turn on brown fat to produce heat. And if you followed any of my books, you know that in the generation of heat, you waste a great deal of calories. You lose weight. And that's why people who live in cold climates tend to have better health than people who don't live in cold climates. Polyphenol ingestion, like olive oil, like extra dark chocolate, like coffee, like green tea or black tea, also stimulates brown fat production and heat. Okay, so what we'd like to do is shift white fat towards brown fat, making it beige. So with the right habits, you can actually encourage this, and you can watch it happen, particularly in experimental animals. So how do you do this? As I just mentioned, one of the easiest ways is cold exposure. Now, you don't have to go jump in a cold plunge all the time. You have a cold plunge exposure in your bathroom. It's called your shower. And just expose yourself at the end of the shower to even 30 seconds or a minute of cold water. It's really all you need. If you live in a cold climate, go outdoors. Now, interestingly enough, heat exposure will do the same thing. When I was a heart surgeon, I did a lot of research in one of these agents called heat shock proteins, which actually protect cells from damage. Saunas are a great way for heat exposure. Come visit me in Palm Springs in the summer. I guarantee you, you will get heat exposure just like a sauna. As I mentioned, polyphenols, like thermogenic spices, like turmeric, for example, ginger, will cause brown fat activation and will cause white fat to become beige. One of the best ways to do this is time-controlled eating or intermittent fasting. the longer that you go in a 24-hour cycle in ketosis, ketones actually cause mitochondrial uncoupling and produce heat and promote the beiging of white fat. So all of these work by the same mechanism, and that is mitochondrial uncoupling. Remember, we produce heat by wasting energy in our mitochondria. And brown fat is one of the best energy wasting systems there is. So mitochondrial coupling, I could spend books telling you about that. Oh, yes, I did spend books telling you about that. But mitochondrial uncoupling merely triggers the body to not only waste energy, but also make more mitochondria. And quite frankly, the more mitochondria you have in your cells, the healthier they are, the healthier you're going to be. So if you're feeling low energy or metabolically off, even with a normal weight, don't ignore this sign. 50% of normal weight individuals are metabolically inflexible. That means you can't make a shift between using glucose as a fuel and burning free fatty acid as a fuel. So visceral fat and low brown fat activity may be actually working against you behind the scenes. The good news? With a few new daily habits, you can reprogram your metabolism, boost your energy, and get back on track.
More amazing episodes just like this one. Watch now.
And if you're constantly eating, you're constantly exposing the wall of your gut to work.